aspects don't just create a dent, they raise some serious questions. LeBron's actions and reactions when it comes to flopping and crying for fouls are increasingly seen as detracting from the qualities typically attributed to GOATs. I mean, we never saw Mike cry after a missed call, or Kobe.
Mm-hmm.
And the truth is, LeBron is losing respect because of it. Like, for example, when Dylan Dynasty Brooks recently swiped down on LeBron James, pay close attention to the commentator's response during the replay.
Is it a foul, or was this a flop?
It's gotten so bad that every time there's a significant LeBron reaction where his arms are flailing in the air, we gotta rewatch the footage to see if it is a genuine foul or another case of flopping. Then, there's also the matter of how long LeBron remains on the ground after these incidents. It feels like he's there for eternity. In fact, he often spends more time on the floor than it takes Giannis to complete his entire free throw routine, which is saying something. Now, compare that to Kobe Bryant's reaction when he was clotheslined by Rajah Bell. The man just got right back up almost instantly and even smiled.
Yep.
Now, don't get me wrong. LeBron is undoubtedly one of the game's all-time greats. In many ways, his accomplishments stand shoulder to shoulder with Michael Jordan's. Yes, Jordan
Negro,
has two
please.
Rings, but LeBron is the all-time leading scorer and has faced tougher competition in the finals. I mean...
Bro. This guy was doing good until he wasn't. If you want to be technical, MJ has a ridiculously, an absurdly higher number of awards in a way shorter, in half the time basically, or a fourth of the time almost compared to LeBron. Scoring only matters if you win championships, people. It's the whole point of the fucking game of basketball, is to score more than your opponent. So, you LeBron fans out there, y'all go do some calculations and figure out an equation in the algorithmic world of the internets, the interwebs. There's 8 billion of us out here, and I know y'all can do it, but y'all do me this solid. Get all them points that matter so much, and go figure out an equation that can get him some championships. Can y'all do that for me? I mean, it's so many points. It's so amazing. It's all these points, and it's just, he still got what? 4 championships? So, where are the awards? Where are the championships? Where are the accolades? Where is it written that if I have 10 super duper feeder supply pet champion awards of the year in a row, never missed a day, I never cheated work, I never cheated the customer, I never cheated the pets, I did the thing to the utmost degree. Okay. Compared to somebody that's been there twice as long as me and only has 3 awards of the same ilk, cut from the same cloth. So, mathematically speaking, we got to go by the numbers. And let's say I work half the amount of hours that homeboy works, and he works three times as much as I do, but still only has those three awards to my 10, and I've worked half the time. How then can you say that this person is better than me? The points, the hours are irrelevant. It's about the end result being the very best that you can be, getting the highest accolade consistently. And that's what MJ has done. These are facts, people. These are facts. Stop riding that number dick. Y'all are getting off on it too much. Stop it. Let it go. Just let it go, y'all. It's over. It's over. LeBron never had a chance. He never had a chance. Y'all's in denial. Go to therapy. See a psychiatrist. Ask your mommy for a hug. Cry in your wife's arms in the fetal position and tell her how you feel. But let it go. Just let it go. What's that saying? If you love her, you'll let her go. If you love yourself, you'll let this go. It's tearing y'all up, and you're trying to find a way to make something possible that was never going to come to fruition in the first place. So it's like every year you just want to add on some little ticky-tack thing, as if 30,000 or 40,000 points can be broken up and mailed over to Adam Silver, and in return you get more trophies. We've all had them games where you score 20 points and you play to 32 and you lose by 2, even though you was up by 12. So it don't matter. The points are irrelevant if it doesn't convert to victory. Any competition is about victory. MJ has more victories, y'all. Fuck points. Leave a comment. You know that I know, that we all know, that LeBron know, that MJ know, but he don't even have to acknowledge this foolishness because it's foolishness. What business does an ace have being around a king? Actually, no, I mean a queen. It's Queen James, y'all. Y'all got it twisted. His wife is harder than he is. This nigga's 6'9", 250, all muscle, has literally the best healthcare, the best everything in the world, and cries like a small child. LeBron cries more than Bronny was when he was newborn. And he was confused because in his soul he knew he was black, and this white lady holding him, and he butt naked, and he don't know what's going on, and he's crying for his life. And then mommy come and hold him, and everything's all right. LeBron, you're a bitch. You're a big old bitch. You have whole behavior. You have women tendencies. You're too feminine. You're constantly emasculating yourself. You're making big niggas that are black, that are great athletes, that are real men, that don't flop and cry like a little bitch, that just got hit by their daddy for the first time. And the son's like, "Daddy, why?" You know that hit. You just... And it's... That's what LeBron does. Just like that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. You know what's coming. You know what's coming. Why does nigga look like there's a emergency event and he's trying to jump in front of a small child just like Kane in Minister Society? That's a time where you would cry. When you getting lit up by the Compton Crips. Know what I mean? But this ain't no gangbang activity. There ain't no firearms involved. This is just who LeBron is. So, can I say this without mentioning Manu? No. I don't respect Manu's part of that game either. I say the same thing to him. Ain't nobody special. Real niggas don't flop. Real men don't flop. That's like being a boxer and getting punched. And you're like, "Oh no, Mr. Mike Tyson, Mr. Boxer Man, please don't punch me. It hurt too bad." Nigga, that's what you signed up for. I've been kneed, I've been kicked, I've been pushed, I've been clotheslined, I've been slammed, I've been everything. And I ain't never once cried. I never have. Never. It's never happened. Ask anybody that's ever played with me, it's never fucking happened. I don't flop. The only time I go back is if there's a big motherfucker and he like shoulders my ass or backs me down and he's just too damn big. Because I'm 5'11 and a half and I always get stuck guarding the nigga that's fucking 6'6, 220 pounds. I'm a great defender, but I'm not as big as, I'm 5'11. I'm not fucking 6'6. So I struggle with that. But I don't cry about it. If I catch an elbow, I've got my shit busted open and all types of shit. I almost lost vision in both of my eyes. Was blind, almost blinded in both of my eyes at different times playing ball. I don't cry because I ain't no bitch ass nigga. I'm a real man. It's an insult to every real man out there that cries only when it's necessary. If like they tear their Achilles or like they break their leg or something, yeah, okay. But this nigga LeBron is, and not only that, he's having phantom fouls. He's phantom flopping. Be a man, LeBron. But you can't be, because you are who you are. You're a hoe. You're a hoe. You just happen to be a big ass man on the outside and a little woman on the inside. You should be on that show Little Women with the little short women, because that's the kind of soul you got in you. You're confused, LeBron. You're confused. Imagine how many rebounds and second chance points you would have if you actually went up on a board like I do. No matter who it is at the who, no matter who's around the paint, and will yourself to do better. You have almost 45,000 points, 50,000 points, but now what do you want to do? You want the referee to bail you out. Come on, man. That's fuckboy behavior. Just like in the Pacers game, when you got that charging foul against Roy Hibbert, and then you ran down the court, up and down the court. Remember that, y'all? Look it up. Eastern Conference Finals 2013, Game 7. Or it might have been Game 6. But it was when Paul George was nasty like that. He did that 1-360 dunk. Now y'all telling me that's the GOAT? This nigga's crying, literally running up and down the court for the whole world to see, and this is y'all's, this is your goat? So y'all respect bitches that are men, that have hoe behavior, that are feminine, that emasculate men, that make the Hafthor Julius Bjornsons, the Eddie Halls, the Brian Shaws, the Maris Pujanovskis, the Mike Tysons, the Muhammad Ali. Shout out to my uncle Muhammad, rest in peace. So you telling me that this nigga, LeBron, should be mentioned in the same breath as them? Hey, ladies, let me ask y'all something. Get your mans and observe him next time he plays ball. Like, with a lot of people, like playing, like seriously. And tell me if he acts the same way LeBron does. I guarantee 99.9% of y'all is gonna say no. You know why? Because they ain't homemade. It must be some shit that they putting in that water up in there in Akron, Ohio. And I'm from Louisville, motherfucking Kentucky, nigga. And this is basketball country, all right? We take ball 100% serious here. And we ain't got no respect for no motherfucking dude that plays like that, because you'll get ran off the court. You won't even be able to play. You won't even be able to play. You do that shit in church, I'll forget I'm in church, and I'll, Lord forgive me. I'll be like, oh, wait a minute, I'm in church. I need to chill out. But I can't let it slide, though. So, y'all think I'm playing? I don't give a fuck if there's 20 niggas. I'll tell the dude. I don't give a fuck who you with. I don't care what you're trying to pop a trunk with. I'll pop my trunk, too, and get a Kool-Aid. You want one? But you're going to got me all in my feelings, making me interrupt my World of Warcraft stream to fucking call this nigga out. Ladies, would y'all marry a man that acts the same way as a nerd that can't really defend himself and has never been in a bad situation, never had a gun poured on him, never got into a fight, never got arrested, never got into a barroom brawl, never had to defend his girl and knew he was going to get his ass kicked, but he took the L anyway because he loved her though? Would y'all marry a nigga like that? Like LeBron? With this hoish behavior? Would you marry him? Would you marry a Kleenex silk cotton, softer than my kitty cat's fur, because I love my babies and I take the best care of them ever and their fur is so soft. Would you, plus a cupcake, plus a freshly baked apple pie, and then you put the knife in it and it is right through because it's soft. You don't even have to cut it or put pressure or nothing. And then when the wind blows, this nigga's gone with the wind. And then you kick the nigga out at the door, and LeBron's like, baby, what am I supposed to do now? And you hit him with it. What y'all hit him with? Y'all know what it is. Frankly, dear, I don't give a damn. Would y'all marry this main ingredient of Kleenex? Would you? Stewie Griffin's harder than this nigga is. Real talk. Alfalfa's harder than he is. Yeah. Yeah. Y'all let me know, man. Get in the comments. Let me know.